The name pomegranate comes from two Latin words for seeded and apple. The tree is native to ancient Iran, that is Persia. Pomegranate is one of the ancient table fruits in India also. It is grown all over India and commercially in Maharashtra, which is occupying more than 60% of the area, followed by Gujarat, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Pomegranate is called Anar in Hindi and Madalambalam in Tamil and Malayalam, Talambi in Kannada and Danima in Telugu. The edible part of pomegranate is a juicy outgrowth of the seed, which is called the aril. It is valued for refreshing juice and its medicinal properties. The bark and the rind of the fruits are commonly used in dysentery and diarrhea. Tannin is obtained from the fruit rind, leaves, stem and the root bark. Flowers yield red dye, which is used for dyeing the clothes. Pomegranate, an attractive shrub or small tree which grows up to 20 to 30 feet of height, much branched, more or less spiny and is in perennial in nature. It has a strong tendency to sucker from the base. The leaves are evergreen or deciduous, opposite or in whorls of 5 or 6 in number, short stemmed, oblong to lanceolate in shape. Showy flowers are borne on the branch tips, either singly or as many as 5 in a cluster. The fruit has a tough leathery skin or rind, basically yellow, more or less overlaid with light or deep pink or rich red color. The interior is separated by the membranous walls and white spongy tissue into compartments packed with transparent sacs filled with aerials. In each sac, there is one white or red angular or soft or hard seed. Both types of seeds are present in different cultivars. Hence, hard-seeded and soft-seeded cultivars are known in pomegranate. Pomegranate is rich in vitamin C, vitamin K and foliate. Pomegranate seeds are edible and excellent source of dietary fiber. Pomegranate seed oil contains punic acid about 65.3%, palmitic acid 4.8%, stearic acid 2.3%, oleic acid 6.3% and linoleic acid about 6.6%. Now we will see the climate and soil requirement of pomegranate. Pomegranate can be grown in tropical to warm temperate climates and from plains up to an elevation of about 1800 meters above mean sea level. The tree requires hot and dry climate during fruit development and ripening. It cannot produce sweet fruits unless the temperature is high for a considerable period. The plants withstand considerable amount of drought but does well if provided with irrigation. Regarding the soil, deep loamy or alluvial with good drainage having a pH of 6.8 to 8 is good for pomegranate cultivation. However, it can be grown on soils which are considered to be unsuitable for most of the other fruit trees. Plants can tolerate soils which are limey and slightly alkaline too. Soil having waterlogging properties are not good for pomegranate cultivation. In these soils, the incidence of the diseases, pest becomes severe, ununiform growth of the plants will be seen. Besides defoliation and flowering, treatments to the plants becomes more difficult. Now we will see the different varieties in pomegranate. Mostly pomegranate cultivars originated as seedling selections. Some promising cultivars have also been developed through controlled hybridization. The recommended cultivars are area specific, for example, Kandhari and Naba for North Plains, Jalor Seedless and Jodhpur White in Rajasthan, Vellodu in Tamil Nadu area, Dholka in Gujarat, Basi in Seedless, Bhagava for Karnataka, and Pule, Arka and Ganesh in Maharashtra. Some of the important cultivars we will see now. One is Pepper Shell. It is grown in South India. Fruits are medium to large in size. Flesh is pinkish and seeds are soft. The aerial has good flavor with very high fruit bearing capacity. Next variety is called Alandi or Vatki. It is commonly grown in Maharashtra and Gujarat. Fruits are of medium size, blood red in color or deep pink flesh with sweet, slightly acidic with more juice content. Seeds are very hard. Ganesh, it is a selection from Alandi. The fruit is medium in size, soft seeded, aerial is pink, high yielding with average fruit weight of about 325 gram, sweet in round in shape, TSS about 16.45%, acidity about 0.42%. Next variety is Jodhi. It is a selection from Basin Seedless variety developed by the University of Agriculture Science, Bangalore. Fruits are bigger in size with attractive red color, soft seeded, more flesh, having a TSS content of about 16%. Next variety is Mridula. It is a seedling selection from an open pollinated F2 population of a cross Ganesh and Gulli Shan Red. Fruits are red in color and round shape with sweet, aerial, soft seeded fruit. Next is Jalor Seedless. It is a soft seeded variety. Fruit matures yearly and maximum fruit production is coincided with available soil moisture during monsoon. Large fruits about 200 gram with pink to deep red skin. Aerials are pink to red, having soft seeds with attractive overall appearance of the fruit. Another variety is the Ruby, which is a hybrid between Ganesh, Gapur and Yerkad. The fruits resembles like Ganesh variety with reddish brown skin with green stripes on skin, soft seeded with bigger size and red colored aerials, heavy yielder, say 16 to 18 tonnes per hectare. Bhagava, which is the recent variety and a ruling variety, fruit is glossy red in color with soft seeds. Fruit weighs between 250 to 500 gram. And the other varieties popularly grown are Dholka, Gandhari, Kabul, Muscat, Jodhpur Red, etc. Now we will see the propagation method in pomegranate. Pomegranate is successfully propagated by hardwood stem cutting and air layering. In the case of stem cutting, the cuttings are collected from high yielding plants, 1 year old and fully matured shoots. About 25 to 40 centimeter long cutting should be planted by removing the leaves and treating the bottom end of the cutting with the rooting hormone, namely IBA 2000 ppm, and inserted in the soil. Plants will be ready within a period of 50 to 60 days. Second method is through air layering. It is done during rainy season. The bottom of the upper cut can be treated with IBA 10,000 ppm for better rooting in the layers. The third method is through tissue culture. Plants are commercially propagated through tissue culture also and is made available by many private companies in India. Planting season. Pomegranate grows more vigorously under bright sunlight rather than cloudy weather. Pomegranate plant grows well during dry conditions rather than humid. Therefore, pomegranate plantation is highly recommended after completion of the rainy season. In respect of land preparation and method of plantation, the land should be plowed with rotavator for 2 to 4 times and leveled. Then they are allowed for sun drying for about 2 to 4 weeks. 8 to 10 tractor trolleys load of farmyard manure is spread over the field uniformly. Depending on the soil quality, planting may be performed either on pits or raised bed. Pit planting is recommended for highly drained, sandy, soft rocky soil, while raised bed planting is recommended for deep loam, alluvial soil. A pit size of 3 feet into 3 feet into 3 feet is recommended for sandy, soft rocky, very highly drained soil, while a pit size of 2 into 2 into 2 feet is recommended for moderate drained soil, whereas 1 foot into 1 foot into 1 foot pit is recommended for well drained soil. In respect of bed size, it should be enough wide for spread of the roots and high to remove excessive water from the bed that help for the growth of the whole roots. The ideal size of the bed is 3 feet wide, 2 feet high. 1 into 1 foot pit must be dug out at the planting place over the bed. The components and quality of the potting media per pit are as namely 2 parts of soil and 1 part of farmyard manure, that is about 20 kg per plant, with 1 kg of neem cake along with 250 grams of superphosphate and 250 gram of potash and 25 gram of furodon, besides 5 gram of bevistine and 5 gram of bleaching powder. Components must be mixed thoroughly before putting it in the pit. Pomegranate should be planted on square system of planting at a distance of 5 meter into 5 meter apart. Evergreen cultivars may be planted at even a closer spacing of 4 into 4 meter spacing. Thus, 400 to 625 plants can be planted in an hectare area. The best time for planting of pomegranate is December, January. Now we will see the planting and cropping system followed in pomegranate. Rooted cuttings or layers of 12 to 18 months age can be planted during June to December months. In respect of training and pruning, normally no importance is given to the training of pomegranate plants. Pomegranate is left as such to grow as a bush which is not desirable. Plants can be trained as single stemmed tree, example Kandari, and 2 to 4 stemmed bushes in respect of evergreen plants. Multi-stemmed trained plants create problems later as on the stems intermingling with each other. Pomegranates preferably be trained as single stemmed to get strong scaffold system. No branch should be allowed to develop from ground level to 30 cm of the trunk height. Heading back of the leader at 1 meter height to force the scaffold branches to develop is recommended. Select only 4 to 5 well placed scaffolds on all sides of the main trunk. If plants are trained on 2 or 3 stems, then the plant is develop a balanced scaffold system. Here we have to remove only the intermingling branches from the stem. It has been recorded that deciduous cultivars perform better as single stem trees and evergreens with multiple stems, 2 to 3 stems in the trained material. With reference to pruning, pomegranate generally do not require annual pruning. The fruit is borne on short spurs as well as in the leaf axils and shoot apex. Remove crisscrossing and dried branches. Some branches may be headed back during December by removing 30% of the growth to encourage fresh growth. Removal of water shoot is an important operation in pomegranate cultivation. Pomegranate trees tends to produce water shoots during its whole life cycle. Water shoots are produced more extensively during first 18 months, that is during vegetative phase. If not removed at appropriate time, it stops the growth of normal shoots. Water shoots are produced at two major locations, first at the bottom of the tree, while second is from the stem of the canopy. Identification and removal of water shoot is very important. Water shoots grow straight and long without producing branches. Stem is green at early stage. With reference to propping, pomegranate wood is brittle that cannot bear the heavy fruit weight. It requires propping 2 to 3 months prior to maturity of the fruits. Cost of propping increases over the trees that have long branches. Propping can be of two types. First one is temporary type, second one is a permanent type. In temporary propping, threads are used to hold the loaded branches, while in permanent propping, either bamboo or steel rod or pipe or angles are used. Now we will see the water, nutrient and weed management in pomegranate. Newly planted orchard requires frequent and regular irrigation during flowering and fruiting. Orchard should be irrigated regularly to avoid cracking of fruits and for better development of the fruits. In respect of intercropping and intercultural operation, leguminous vegetables and cereals can be taken up during pre-bearing stage. Papaya can be taken up as a filler plant. Basin should be maintained free from weeds. Deep flowering should be avoided as it damages the roots. In respect of manure and fertilizers, pomegranate is a hardy plant, but it responds well to manure and fertilizers. Application of about 20 to 50 kg of formian manure per tree for bearing trees per year, along with 40 grams of nitrogen, 200 gram of phosphorus and 200 gram of potash per tree is required. For pre-bearing plants, full doses of P, K and 3/4 of N should be given at the time of flowering. Remaining 1/4 of nitrogen is given at 1.5 months after fruit setting. At the age of 8 to 10 years, these doses should be doubled. Weed control is an essential operation. Since pomegranate is closely planted, use of a tractor to intercultivation is not possible or not desirable. Weed should be manually hence removed by hoeing the basin once in December at the time of fertilization, then again in May. In respect of the special horticultural techniques, to obtain bigger sized fruits of high quality one, there is a need to thin the fruits. As in many other fruit species, there is a negative correlation between the number of fruits, their size. Even distribution of fruits on the branches is desired. About 5 fruits on a group of small branches with a good, say 20 centimeter distance between the fruit is optimum. While a group of fruits develops, the touching of fruits are removed as a measure of thinning out the fruits. Regarding the crop regulation, pomegranate is a precocious bearer. Plants start bearing in the third year of planting. It continues to bear for 30 years. Deciduous cultivars only flower during April, May. The evergreen cultivars flowers throughout the year and bear 3 crops. To obtain good quality of fruits and high yield, select only one crop as suited to the area. Remove the flowers manually for rest of the seasons. Inflorescence is a cyme due to the abscission of the side buds and persistence of the central flower. Flowering appears to be solitary. Keep only one fruit at a place to get well-sized fruits. The flower should be manually removed after mid-April when sufficient number of fruits have already set. On a mature tree, select 80 to 100 fruits only. In respect of pollination, pomegranate bears 3 types of flowers, that is pure male with rudimentary ovary, hermaphrodite with medium style and hermaphrodite with well developed style. The percentage of these flowers varies from cultivar to cultivar. Pollen is available at noon and stigma remains receptive for 2 to 3 days. Both cross as well as self pollination take place in pomegranate. Regarding flower regulation, in central and south India, pomegranate flowers in springs, while in tropics, it flowers in 3 distinct phases with the maximum intensity in rainy season. Spring flowers give fruits in summer but of poor quality. Therefore, it is advisable to get crop from rainy season crop so that maximum water is available in the soil and crop is taken without irrigation. To obtain higher fruit yield during a particular period, pomegranate plants are given a resting period. It is done by withholding water for about 60 days in advance of the normal flowering season. Some of the disorders met in pomegranate cultivation we will see now. One is bacterial blight disease. This is the most devastating disease on pomegranate, which is caused by a bacteria known as Xanthomonas oxynipodes. It is a non-systemic disease that infects leaves, flowers, fruit and stem. The symptoms, you can see the appearance of small irregular water soaked spots on leaves. Spots vary from 2 to 5 millimeter in diameter with necrotic spots at the center of with a pinhead size. Spots are translucent against light. These spots turn light brown to dark brown and are surrounded by prominent water soaked margins. Numerous spots vary, may coalesce to form larger patches. Severe infestation leads to shedding of leaves. The symptoms on the stem starts by forming brown to black spots around the nodes. In advanced stages, girdling and cracking of node occurs, which finally lead to breakdown of the branches. In the case of symptoms on fruits, brown to black spots appear on the pericarp with L or Y shaped cracks on fruits. Bacterial infection can be controlled by infected branches should be pasted with Bodo paste. Spray of the carboxy chloride at the concentration of 0.3% or streptocycline at the rate of 50 to 250 ppm is recommended. After the use of streptocycline, a spray containing 1 gram of zinc sulfate, 1 gram of magnesium sulfate and 1 gram of copper sulfate per liter of water must be given to the plants. Some of the fungal diseases are Fusarium oxysporum, Rhizoctonia solani and Ceratocystis fimbriata. Common symptoms of these diseases are yellowing of leaves in single branch, sudden wilting of leaves and drying of plant, vertical stem cracking and brown discoloration of the internal root tissues and path of the stem. In respect of control measure, soil drenching with carbendazim 0.2% or propinoconazole 0.15% is recommended. Even the biocontrol agents like trichoderma culture can be also given as a prophylactic measure. Alternaria fruit spot caused by Alternaria alternate is a serious disease in pomegranate. The symptoms are small reddish brown circular spots appear on the fruits. As the disease advances, these spots coalesce to form large patches and the fruits start rotting. To control this disease, spraying mangosip 0.2% is recommended. In respect of the insect pest, now we will see the various pests affecting the pomegranate. One is thrips. It infests the fruit as well as the leaves by scraping the tissues and sucking the cell sap. Fruit cracking is also observed. Heavy infestation may cause flower shedding. Leaves curl and they dry. Spraying of systemic insecticides like dimethyl 0.06% or imidacloprid 0.03% Priority flowering is recommended to control this pest. Use of biopesticide spray like neem oil at the rate of 0.5% can be also effective. Next pest is the aphids. It infests tender shoots, flowers, leaves and tender fruits by sucking the cell sap. Excrete large quantities of honeydew on which black sooty mold develops. Spray systemic insecticides like dimethyate at 0.06% or imidacloprid 0.03% or biopesticides like neem oil 0.5% will effectively check this pest. The third one is the mealybug. There are about 20 species of mealybug reported in pomegranate in India. Nymphs and adults suck the cell sap from the leaves, twigs, flowers and fruits. It secretes honeydew that encourages sooty mold development. Regarding the control measure, sticky banding around the stem above 1 feet level help to control the mealybug movement from plant to plant. Prune and destroy the affected parts of the plant. Spraying of chlorpyrifos at the rate of 0.06% and dichlorovas at 0.05% after pruning is recommended. Next is the white fly. They are found on the leaves and cause sooty mold. Nymphs and adults suck the cell sap from the leaves, twigs, flowers and fruits. More incidents occurs during February. To control this, spray astrobrite 0.3 gram per liter or acephate 1 gram per liter. Other pests are fruit borer, bark eating caterpillar, which are very minor or may assume major in certain area. Fruit cracking is a serious physiology disorder in pomegranate. This disorder is due to the prevalence of high temperature and moisture stress followed by rain causing the fruit cracking during fruit development phase. In the younger fruits, it could be due to boron deficiency. Now we will see the maturity indices and harvest. Tree starts bearing fruits from 3 to 4th year after planting and continues for about 25 to 30 years. Pomegranate fruits become ready for harvesting in 5 to 7 months after blossoming. Pomegranate being a non-climatic fruit, it should be picked when fully ripe. Harvesting of the immature or over mature fruit affect the quality of the fruits. Calyx at the distal end of the fruit gets closed on maturity. At maturity, fruits turn yellowish red and get suppressed on sides. The fully grown up tree about 10 years old produces about 80 to 122 fruits, which may ranging from 16 to 20 kg. Regarding the post-harvest management, grading is an important operation. Fruits are graded on the basis of fruit weight and size. For big markets, the grades adopted are 1. Super size, which will weigh more than 750 gram without any spot. Next is the king sized one. The weight ranges from 500 to 750 gram without any spots. Third one is queen sized. The weight is 400 to 500 gram without spots. Then prince sized 300 to 400 gram well colored. Then 12A, which will weigh about 250 to 300 gram without spots, and 12B is 250 to 300 gram with some spots. Based on the shape, color and defect also the grading is done. One is extra class, that is superior shape, color, uniformity, less than 5% defect is normally noted in this case. Class 1, here good shape, color, uniformity and 5 to 10% defect can be permitted. Class 2, here fruits not conforming to extra class or class A will be included under this category. Based on weight and size in diameter also grading is done. A, here minimum weight should be 400 gram, minimum diameter should be 90 millimeter. Next is grade B, here minimum weight is 350 gram and minimum diameter is 80 millimeter. Next is C, here minimum weight is 300 gram and minimum diameter is 70 millimeter. Next is D, wherein The minimum weight should be 250 gram, and the diameter should be around 60 millimeter. The last one is the E. Here minimum weight is 200 gram and minimum diameter is 50 millimeter. In respect of storage, fruits can be stored in cold storage up to 2 months or 10 weeks at a temperature of 5 degree centigrade. Marketing, fruits are packed as per their grade. CFP boxes are generally used for packaging, and fruits are cushioned with the proper paper strips and cut pieces. For small markets, fruits are packed in wooden boxes of 5 to 10 kg of size. While summing up the production technology of pomegranate, we have seen pomegranate is native to ancient Iran, Persia, grown all over India, especially states like Maharashtra, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. Edible part of the pomegranate is a juicy outgrowth of the seed called the aril. The fruit is rich in vitamin C, K and many other nutrients. Pomegranate seeds are edible and excellent source of dietary fiber. Seeds contains many organic acids like punic acid, palmitic acid, stearic acid, oleic acid, etc. It can be grown in deep loamy or alluvial soils with a pH of 6 to 8. And it can be grown from tropical to warm temperate climate and from plains to up to 1800 meter above mean sea level. Some of the important cultivars are Pepper Shell, Alanti, Ganesh, Murdula, Ruby, Bhagwa, etc. Propagated by layering and cuttings, and is a precocious bearer. The first plant will get in third year after planting, and it can continue to bear even up to 30 years. There are number of insect pests, bacterial, fungal and diseases limiting the pomegranate production. Pomegranate fruits become ready for harvest in about 5 to 7 months after blooming. Pomegranate, being a non-climatic fruit, should be packed when fully ripe. Fully grown trees of about 10 years old produces 80 to 120 fruits. And fruits are graded on the basis of fruit weight, size, color, uniformity and defects. They can be stored very well in cold storage up to 2 months or about 10 weeks with a temperature control of 5 degree C.